understand how we got here. But I see that there are gonna be some radical changes in how we manage things that are gonna have to be done.
Yes, that's correct.
And I think that allowing 10 hours to work this out is not enough. And I think that this board should consider staying late tonight. I feel that this, what is in front of me now, I don't even feel is ready for a hearing. It's so off-kilter. And I think that everybody should consider that we're gonna be here late tonight, and that we're gonna have to put a considerable amount of more time into this in order to make this work out. I can't see burdening the taxpayer with that kind of increase.
Well, none of us can see that, Ted. That's a given statement. So, and as far as staying late at night, I'm ready to rock and roll.
I mean, just
that's not a problem.
But
the hearing was determined, and everyone voted on it, and we set the hearing, and tonight's the hearing.
I understand that, but my point is, as we're convened now, we have limited time, and we have notice time as well.
Mr. Stoloff? Can we adjourn? Can we adjourn the hearing and then hold it?
Continue it? You can continue it day to day.
Okay.
If you want to do that, as long as you're in a regular meeting, you can continue on with this and close the public hearing and then have the work session after. If you would have one or two work sessions at any event.
Yes, sir.
That's up to you. If you can continue the public hearing of the 108, but it talks about continuing the public hearing for day to day. Yeah, the hearing may be adjourned from day to day, but not beyond the 15th day, except in the towns of Westchester and Monroe. you'd have to keep giving notices that this hearing is going on day to day until you close the public hearing. Otherwise, if you close it now, you can still work on the budget.
Just like with any of the laws, I anticipated some rather heavy-duty changes. Is this going to be something that's going to have to result in another hearing?
No, you have the hearing now. You can make the changes. You have to make the changes and have it in accordance with your preliminary budget. So you're going to have to show and come up with a final budget that looks like your preliminary budget in accordance. So, I mean, if you feel more comfortable, it is up to the board. If you feel more comfortable that you're going to continue the hearing from day to day, I didn't look it up to see what they really mean. The language is day to day.
That could be meeting to meeting.
I'm not sure what it means, so I'm not going to give you an opinion, because that would be something I would have looked up for you, because it's unusual to deal with it before I was here tonight.
Can we convene another meeting? Another public?
Well, you then know, you have a public hearing, you're adjourning it day to day. Let me see.
Okay. As it sits right now,
17.35.
That's correct.
17%.
Now that's using our estimate, Mr. Boyce. However, when it's really put into the machine, it usually comes out less. You remember last year it came out to be 19.5, but after it was processed, don't ask me why, it came out to be 16.75. So I don't know if that 17.3 is indeed going to be accurate. But let's use that. We have the number here.
Hopefully it'll be less.
Yeah.
is the board looking at any new revenue sources in order to tone down that number at all?
We have looked to other revenue sources. We have one proposed small business that wants to come in. It's still in the planning phase, and it will be paying rent in one of our buildings that could reduce this somewhat, but I have to tell you, it's not, they're not going to be paying tens and tens of thousands of dollars.
Has the board gone back to the department heads and basically asked them to try and see if they could find more room?
Yes, we do.
Yes, you have.
Yes, sir. And we'll be doing it tomorrow again. Thank you for the question. Yes, ma'am.
At the last budget meeting that I was at, I was asked to write a letter. And I was wondering if you had taken that letter into consideration. I don't see it reflecting on the budget.
Well, we had to discuss that in as a personnel issue. But yes, we received the letter. The letter was distributed to all board members. A chance to read it, review it. And that was after we did this copy. That's why it's not there. This is not reflecting the decision. It's reflecting that the decision was not made at the time this was printed.
Yes, sir. Do you project the surplus at the end of this year?
No. No, sir.
So we're going to spend $1.3 million between now and...
Sir, I said that was including reserve accounts.
Right. How much is the reserve account?
Well... Yeah, can I borrow your meat calculator, Mr. Brebbia? Excuse me.
Day, as long as you pick a date, it doesn't have to be tomorrow, you can adjourn it to another date, and then adjourn it again. So if you want to adjourn it to the date of the session to continue the public hearing, it'll just have to be noticed as a continuation, and you have to advertise it of the public hearing.
Very good. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So it can also be adjourned to the next town board meeting.
Reserve accounts, $602,467.47. That's what are in the reserve accounts.
What, can I ask what the reserve accounts are for?
Sure you can. Reserve accounts are dedicated accounts, Mr. Dunn, where the monies may only be used for that purpose. And I'm quoting an example.
I understand.
Oh, okay. That's what it's for.
We'll have to pay back, though, too.
I'm sorry?
Back.
Yes.
Or within a year plus.
If you borrow from them.
Yes.
Right.
Provided you borrow from them. Within one calendar year.
All right then. We've got a opinion from Mr. Stowe. I would like to withdraw the previous admission to